Hi lovelies, it's me, Simply Sherry, making home and entertaining simple. September is Emergency Preparedness Month. I wanted to film this video earlier, but I had lost my voice for 5 days. I finally found it and I'm gaining it back, so please excuse my voice if it cracks or something like that. Hi Molly, how you doing Molly? Hi Molly. Molly is our dachshund. She's 8 years old. We got her when she was 2 months old. Is it okay, Molly, we show your bug out bag today? Huh? Yeah? Yeah? Now, a bug out bag means that you are leaving the place where you're at, example, your house or your office, and going to another place that is safer. And for short, it's called a BOB, B-O-B. Now, I consider myself a basic prepper. So what I've done is I've color-coded our backpacks. Molly's is pink. When my son was here, it was going to be his duty to carry her backpack. But now that he's off to college, it's my duty to carry the backpack, my husband to take Molly, and my daughter. And my daughter carries her own backpack. My husband carries his own backpack or bug-out bags. So in here are supplies for 3 days. And one of these bottles, the 16.9 ounce bottles, is good for 1 day for Molly. So I have 4 of them here in the side mesh pockets. The challenge is to try to make the bug out bag as light as possible because I will be carrying 2 bags. So that is enough, hopefully enough to get to a safer place. One of those hidden zippers, it is covered with this flap if that's something that you like. And then here, you know, the mesh, there's a little pocket there. And here's the other 2 bottles there. So on this hook, we have this slap wristband that I got from the Dollar Tree so that there is something reflective on the backpack for nighttime. And then I just made this tag with a key ring and I printed this out and laminated it. On the back is her name and my phone number. So for the front pocket, I put more the first aid kit, my information and stuff that would be more like medical. My dog does not have any prescriptions, so if your dog has prescriptions or your animal, your cat has, make sure to put that in here in your bug out bag. This is a pet first aid kit. I believe I got this from Amazon, so I'll try to find that and put it in the description box below. The great thing is that it has a carabiner, and then inside you will see disposable gloves, a wrap, some tape, bandage. Here you can use their pocket first aid manual. Put your information there. And then it just has information here. Since it's a basic pet first aid kit, I thought I'd work with this first. And the backpack has these little slots. Obviously, these would be for pencils and other school supplies. But here I have a hand sanitizer. And then this is for flea and ticks, one-time use. And then these are from the Dollar Tree. They were a pack of 4, I believe, that have these kind of holders on them and then the string for the lanyard. Glow sticks from the Dollar Tree are a great bargain. I like to have glow sticks, especially at nighttime, just to have some lighting if it's going to be pitch black. Here are more glow sticks. It's the ones for bracelets. And in this snack size Ziploc bag, it has the bracelets, connectors there, and then some zip ties. You may always want zip ties for something. And then I have wet wipes. This is a rescue blanket, you know, just to keep warm. These you can get from the Dollar Tree. Her little holder for her poop bags. I also got from the Dollar Tree, it's a magic towel just to wipe up if needed. And then I have an extra harness and leash for her. She already has a leash and harness that is right by the door to the garage. So we can always grab that, but I have an extra one just in case in the chaos I forget to grab her leash. In this snack size Ziploc bag, I have a pen. You always want a pen to write things down in case the battery in your phone goes out. Inside is her vaccination record, and the reason I put it in a Ziploc bag is to protect it from water. And you can always use a Ziploc bag for other stuff. On here is the information for her vet, the address. It's also a hospital. And on the back is my name and phone number. And then you can also put on here a list of at least 3 pet-friendly hotels that you can go to. Again, just think about if things were offline, what information would you need? In the larger compartment, you want to put a pad because the floor might be hard wherever you are going or sheltering. So this is a pad that she has had. So it's familiar to her. The smell is familiar. This is also a blanket that she can snuggle up in. This was actually my daughter's baby blanket, and I let Molly use this when she was a baby. So also she's familiar with this and the smell. A couple toys here. Now this one doesn't make any noise, so that would be good. I put this one that actually squeaks. These two are from the Dollar Tree also. If you're in a large place where other people are sheltering, you may not want them to be bothered with all the squeaking, but I brought this just in case it's something that we could have in the car if we're bugging out that way. Again, I'm putting stuff in Ziploc, not just to organize it or to contain it, but you can use a Ziploc after for other stuff. Collapsible bowls. One is green, one is pink. Green is for the water, pink is for her food. I think I got this on Amazon. You could see the little silhouette of the dog. And it opens up like that. And then it closes again. So that's great because you want to save space. Then here is the one for food, and it's the same exact size, just a different color. Her booties, and I got these because if you are bugging out and there's mud, gravel, rocks, glass around, you want to protect her feet. It's nice and soft, and there's some breathable material here. This is Velcro that can wrap around the ankle and has some reflective element there. And then padding here. Now, the ones selling on Amazon have different sizes, and it tells you usually how to measure your pet's paw or paws, and so you can decide which size. These are medium because she has longer nails. And lastly, in this gallon size Ziploc, I have her food. And I got all of these from the Dollar Tree. Her first bug out bag, I had canned food and a can opener, but to lighten that, I went ahead and got some food that is already in pouches. Okay, so here are the snacks, the dental, a Ziploc here with spoons, three spoons and three knives, and that is so I can scoop out the food and put it into her bowl if needed. I should be able to squeeze it out from this pouch, but this is just in case. Three bags here. And I've separated them by day because this is a 3-day bug out bag. It says here, feed 3 pouches daily per 10 pounds of adult dog. So my dog is 17 pounds, 3 times 1.5, right? But I think that's still too much for her. 3 pouches for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And if she's still hungry, I have the snacks. Chicken casserole and gravy, meaty ground dinner with slow cooked beef. Beef, bacon, and cheese flavors. If I want, I could also label these 1, 2, and 3 for day 1, 2, and 3 if necessary. If you have a bug out bag for your pet, please let me know what you put in there. If there's anything that I'm missing in here, I'd say this is a basic bug out bag that you could start with. If you're new to my channel, please hit the subscribe button. I'd love to have you on this journey with me to making home and entertaining simple. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye. I'm waiting long for you, so be my princess for life.